Oral history is about memory and what someone remembers from an experience, and that's what this is about, the human experience of war. And to hear someone tell about what it felt like, what they were doing, why they did it, why they joined the military, makes it a very rich account. And, you know, too often today we read histories that are written by generals or strategists or major historians, but what this project does, what the Veterans History Project does, is tell the war at the grassroots level, as let someone who was in the foxhole or even in the mess tent or the motor pool tell about what it was like to go off to war, the tediousness of war, the valor of war, the horror of war. All those come into play when you get this kind of grassroots level look at war and the accounting through an oral history. I think the ones that strike me most, particularly come out of World War II, my dad was a World War II veteran, and you hear these stories of these men and women who came from pretty meager surroundings. And pretty meager backgrounds who made the decision to go off the war, particularly women who went off to be nurses overseas. A story that sticks with me is a gentleman by the name of Mr. Porter from West Virginia who lived in the hills of West Virginia, never thought about flying an airplane but was kind of caught up in all that and went off to Europe and was an ace over Germany. And you think about, you know, from his meager beginnings to the skies over Germany during World War II, doing some pretty valorous things. Those are inspiring, and that's part of what this project is all about, to inspire people to do something, to serve their nation, to do something a little bit bigger than themselves. The freedoms and the privileges that we so richly care for today in this nation are because of veterans and what they have done in serving around the world to keep freedom alive. That's what's important about Veterans Day. That's why every Veterans Day we should take the opportunity to thank those who have served.